You okay?
Okay.
Like my own bleeding heart, thanks.
Richard told me to, I'm just telling you. Beg Richard. Shame of Richard.
All right. Because this has to got something, I've got to talk about something to do with history. So I thought I'm going to talk about the history of T-shirts as art. And as you can tell, a lot of these T-shirts are really well worn, and that's because they've been out on the street a lot. And one of the T-shirts we did, I'm trying to remember which one it is. It could be the Nothing About Us Without Us, which is so beautifully modelled by Tara in the centre. It's a red hand print. Could you have a wander about so people can see it? Yeah, cool. Go and flash yourself about.
Don't tell the benefits agency.
Yeah. So, well, it's one of the slogans that disabled people have adopted. It's also related to one of the actions we did as Dan, which was when the 1997 Blair government got in after 13 years of Tories, and everybody was thrilled, and that lasted all of 5 minutes until we realised that the new Labour government was going to be just as punitive towards disabled people as previous governments had been. So we decided to do an action just to remind the Labour government that disabled people had voted to get them in, and we weren't about to put up with a bunch of cuts. So how we did this was we went to 10 Downing Street, and you know, like good cripples, we brought our packed lunches with us, and so we had these little takeaway boxes on our laps. But in fact, what they had inside them was red paint. And at a crucial point, we took off the lids of the food cartons and threw the red paint at the door of 10 Downing Street. And so the handprint that was dipped in red paint has been captured on that T-shirt based on that action that we did in 1997. It was a few days before Christmas, and so we had really original slogans like Scrooge Blair. But it was a sign, because Dan, one of the things that Dan, which is the Disabled People's Direct Action Network, it's what we did. We did direct action, but we also focused what we did. And one of our big campaigns was, as Susie says, transport and getting on buses. And, you know, we think about it now, 20 years ago, 25 years ago, if you were a wheelchair user, you couldn't get on the bus. If you had any kind of mobility impairment, you couldn't get on the bus. If you were visually impaired, you wouldn't have a clue what bus stop you were at, because there were no announcements on the bus about where you were arriving. And so all of those things, you know, the public transport system was so misnamed because it wasn't accessible to millions of people that are part of society but that were excluded because we couldn't actually get around. And so I've forgotten to bring this T-shirt. I didn't have time to bring them all, to talk about them all, but we had one of our early T-shirts, We Will Ride. And again, we stole that slogan from the American direct action movement, ADAPT, and they managed to get that done. They managed to get accessible transport, and so did we. We're still working on it. And for those of you that don't know, Dan hasn't been active for quite some time, but each time a Tory opens their mouth, I just get more and more enraged. And so do a lot of other disabled people. So we figured it's time to get back out on the street. And it always makes me feel slightly odd being inside one of these buildings, because mostly I'm used to being outside on the street, chained to something. And yeah, perhaps when we leave here, who knows? It's enough of us. It's the day of the budget, what the hell? Time to make an impact. So on the end, we have another Dan T-shirt. Dan Dares is the slogan, and it's the slogan Dan Dares is punching through a brick wall. And underneath it, we've got the slogan that says tear down the walls. And one of the things that we were talking about, and very apt today, is that people are being forced back into institutional care. How can this happen? We fought for years to get disabled people the support in the community that they needed. And if one disabled person goes institutional care, then we have failed. And we need to get people out of those places and back in the communities where they belong and where we belong. So that was a campaign that was called Free Our People, and we really need to be talking about how we can make sure that disabled people continue to have and maintain the resources where, that we can live how we choose. And then finally, this was one of our early t-shirts. This is one for the nerdy Star Trek people in the audience. Split infinitives and everything. It was to boldly go where all others have gone before. The slogan is rights now. So at the top it says disability rights, the final frontier. And it's the slogan is rights now. And you know, again, you think about it, until 19... whenever it was.
When, oh,
95. Yeah, I know, it was such a crappy act. Yeah. But yeah, we got, we campaigned for anti-discrimination legislation, and we got it. And it wasn't what we wanted, but at least it was an acknowledgement that disabled people face discrimination. And that was a move in the right direction. And so that was the t-shirt that was sort of, you know, moving in the direction of saying we've got to have some kind of protection so that every time we go out and face systematic discrimination, at least now we can try and do something about it. And a few high profile court cases, I think, were quite useful for us in terms of services and service providers and employers getting that little bit more scared about discriminating. And I've been told that when they heard the name Dan, they started to get a bit nervous. So if there's any people here in this audience called Dan, you have a legacy.